Once we have selected the element, then we can manipulate the element by setting new values to its property. Let's see a demo here. I have a simple HTML document here with an image and a paragraph. Okay, the image have an ID of image-cup and a width of 250 pixel set to it. So let's select the cup image here by using the query selector. So and let's select it by using its ID, which is image-cup. Okay, so we just selected the document, sorry, the element of the image element. Now, you might find that you might have to do it again and again by using the documented query selector. So one of the way you can do is actually you can assign a variable to this. So let's do it over here, which I'm going to use it throughout this course. So I'm going to assign, let's say, image is equal to selector. Okay, so now image is equivalent to this text, the image that we have selected. So now if I just type image, as you can see, it's the same thing as what we have over here. Okay, so now let's see the width of the image, this image element. So what we can do is we can just use the width using the dot notation and specify the property called width, and you can see it's 250. So let's say if we want to assign this particular image element and to a new width, say 400 pixel. So what you need to do is you just use an equal sign. Let's say assign to 400 instead of 250. So what you will see is that the image actually resized to 400. Now if we go back to the elements and we inspect the elements of this image element, you'll find out that the width now changed to 400. So this is like going into the element and change it manually, like what we saw during our last CSS class, but this time we change it using JavaScript. You also notice that it did not change the original HTML file, as you can see on the VS Code on the left, and the original HTML file remains intact. So if we reload this page, alright, and then you can see that the web page go back to the original, which is the one that is displayed in the VS Code on the left, and the changes that we have made have actually disappeared. Now, besides changing the width of the image, we can also actually changing other attribute as well. Even things like IDs, so and so on. So I'm not going to show you here, but you can try it out yourself as an exercise. Okay. Besides changing the attribute, you can also change the style and the content of the element. Let me clear this. Okay. So let's do the changes to the paragraph element. We can change the style. So again, I'm going to assign a constant called p. Okay, so if let's see what the style is going to be like. So you can see from here that is actually the color. So let's say if you want to change your text color to blue, so what you need to do is just assign this to a new CSS declaration, say color now change to blue. And you can see that the text color changed actually to blue. So if we go and inspect the elements again, and you can see that the style of the paragraph element have color blue. Now, besides changing the style of the element, you can actually also change inner text or the content of the element. So let's change the paragraph, the content of the paragraph. So if I type in the text over here, it actually display the content as it is. Now let's change the content to, let's say, I am an apparel. If I press enter here, as you can see, it changed the content immediately. So if you go back to the elements, you can see also that the content of the paragraph element have also changed. So this is how you can change the property value of the document object by using the query selector and reassign the value as you desire.